morning. It's time for 59 Minutes. My name is David Connors. We're going to be discussing about matters to do with depression and suicide amongst young people. And to join me in that discussion on this lovely morning is a gentleman and a lady from the Presbyterian University. Please welcome Ezra Ruto and Sheila Jepkemboi. Karibu sana.
Asante sana.
Thank Glad you. To have you here.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. When we've talked about matters to do with depression and especially that, you know, unfortunately leads to suicide amongst young people, and the statistics are quite overwhelming. You know, they say 35% of students are depressed, and out of those 35%, very close to 40% take their own lives. And the numbers are staggering. Let's just start from you know, the basics and knock off some of the common reasons why people slide into depression as students. You guys are students.
Yeah.
Your parents are expecting that you've gone to school, possibly if they have raised your money to pay your school fees, or you have gotten loans, they're thinking, mko sawa. So what happens when you get into campus?
So first of all, when we get to university, we are taken to this mentality whereby, yes, you've already gotten to the university. So the grades should be high, and expecting that maybe everything will be the same, but that doesn't happen, because as we are going to the university, we are going to meet a lot of things, a lot of challenges out there. First of all, about the finance. As you have said, Levy, about the HELB loan. Okay, most of the parents, they always put in their mind that it's just about the amount and you're good. No, it's not about that, because university students have a lot of needs to make. Examples are just like food, not food alone. We've got the exams, especially the CATs. The CATs, we always write them and type in them. So we need the money. So if you give me this certain amount, this perspective like, so this amount will it run to me? Maybe some parents give the upkeep maybe to up to a certain, maybe a week. After that week, they believe that maybe if you ask them within the 3-period day, and they'll be like, you're spending the amount so badly. Yeah.
Are you living beyond your means?
Somehow. Because, Levy, if you look at the issue of depression, most of us tend to fall into depression because we are tackling the issue of finances. Finance, I think it's one of the main reasons as to why many students are, we are living beyond our means, as you said it. I come to campus, I meet a person, I don't know where they've come from, I don't know who their parents are. I come from the village. I come from a small village, maybe in Eldoret or Kitale, and I come to Nairobi, I meet people. The university is very classy. A lot of people classy, from the way we dress, from the way we talk, from the way we write, everything that we do in campus, it's all about class and who you know. So a lot of us are forced into, we are being pushed into the hall. The situations are overwhelming. You have to run this, you have to fit in through the shoe of your friends. Your friend is holding a party, you also want to hold the same, you want to do this. So most of us start now developing those thoughts of depression, because it is depression in the meantime that will automatically lead to suicide, because we are talking of the same suicide. So the first issue, I think, is the issue of finance. And another main reason, Levy, is the issue of self-esteem, the issue of how you take yourself, is the subjective value of your self-worth, how you carry yourself. You know, most young people, we cannot love ourselves the way we are, and that's a big issue. At home, we are only surrounded with our siblings. I know of my brother. My brother will automatically appreciate me the way I am. My parents will appreciate me the way I am. But here I am in campus. Here I've been exposed to another different environment where I have to fit in. I have to look at the size of my nose and love it. I have to look at the way my eyes are, and I love them. I have to look at the size of my ears, whether they're this way or this way. I have to love them. I want another person to appreciate what I am. In real sense, I cannot be what that person wants to be. So I think young people, we have to accept, and I'll say this with no fear of contradiction, you have to accept yourself the way you are. You have to accept your financial situation at home the way it is. Number two, you have to accept the way you are. Just love yourself. Whether you are beautiful, ugly or not, that is automatically up to you. Because the way you think of yourself is the way you automatically will be. So I think the first issue is this issue of finances. Let's just fit in. Let's just accept the conditions.
Let me just say, still on that issue of finances, you know, when you say accept yourself the way you are, easier said than done, eh? For the most part, because that peer pressure is, it's a real, it's a real issue. And you know, when people talk about peer pressure, imagine that it starts and ends in campus, but it doesn't. Because even out here in the working world, watu wanapimana sana.
Yeah,
you know, what are you driving? You know, where are you living? You know, where are you vacationing? Yeah. You know, what are you eating? We're always posting everything, you know.
Yeah, sure.
You know, if you're wearing a watch, what type is it? Mm-hmm. You know, if it's your phone, who made it? You know, there's a lot of that focus doesn't end there. Since it is a lifelong focus, do you find that when you're being spoken to or having conversations, are the conversations candid in campus? Do you guys get real with each other, and do your parents get real with you?
No.
Okay, I can say that we always have real talks. Like as a girl, like going back to campus, talking with my girls in our cubicle and saying these are the facts, these are how we can face it. Okay, we speak the same language, we accept everything, but what they practice, the total opposite.
Yeah, and also live even away from that. You know, girls are better off they can.
Kuna reality na social media.
Because we are in a social media era, Levi. Everyone is posting. I have around maybe 120 contacts on WhatsApp. Do you know each day as I tap on each person, I must know where that person is. I can easily track you.
Through your WhatsApp status. Your life
basis. Yeah. Just on WhatsApp status. I'm not going to Facebook and was of it all for the girls, TikTok and Instagram. Because that is where their life is. So there is a lot of pressure. But that is life anyway. So even when Sheila here says that girls do talk, it's a bit different for the boys. Let me speak on behalf of the boys. Because they're a bit different. Levi, it's difficult for me as a young person or as a boy to meet another friend of mine and we sit down, we now tell each other, you see guy, hapa penye tumefika, manze, this is the only way out, this is the solution to our problems. It's very difficult. Because when we meet, we have Ruto who has been denied a chance to go to Uganda. If I'm a Kale, I must talk about that. Number two, we have Manchester United. The league is about to begin. We talk about that. We talk about lecturers. We talk about fancy cars. So there is a lot of cloud.
So your topics are just
things. Yeah.
Superficial.
They're not real issues.
Yes.
Yeah.
You don't talk about why you're broke.
We don't talk. Why is it? How can we change our situation today? It's very difficult. Like, I don't have money today. I don't remember the last conversation. Maybe apart from the mentorship that I do, I don't remember the last conversation that I had with my friend about how is it that we want to better our lives in the next 4 weeks. And I have to say this, there is no fakest. You know, Levi, you've said about friends everywhere. There are fake friends all over. The cloud is all over. The smoke is all everywhere. Mm-hmm. It's okay. But there is no fakest set of friends as those that are in campus. These friends in campus, they pamper you around celebrations. They only know you in times of celebration. You know, they're like shadows.
Yeah.
They're only during the day. At night, you look at the back, there is nobody.
During the time you need them.
There is no one. We can't talk real
that
issues.
That time you can say, bro, waze, nimekuwa broke. Hey.
So that's one factor.
Yeah, that is one factor that triggers the same.
It's that the finances and then the peers, the people with the people
pressure
around you.
Yeah.
Another factor would be the relationships.
Relationships.
Love matters.
Mnaona kwa campus sana.
Mbaya sana.
Exactly. So talking about that.
You have
point.
Yeah.
In most of these universities, I can say from the statistics, a lot, not even public universities alone, but also the private universities.
Yeah.
A girl just
even the colleges,
even the colleges, you know.
KMTC.
Okay, exactly.
I can't believe my daughter's in KMTC.
So the parents can even.
But I hear you.
The parents can even pay for the hostel fee, but the girl, the boy, they just move out to the outside. They go rent a house. Yeah.
So live as she
likes. How they renting the house with what money?
The boy isn't living in the hostel.
The other day Sheila was telling me something, I think I'll say it. She has got a friend or something that she's supposed to be living in the hostel as a girl. Because, you know, parents tend to be overprotective with girls.
Yeah.
Not with boys.
We pay for hostels. Mtapatiwa
4,000 niambiwa enda tafuta nyumba ishi venye
unataka.
Jipange. But for the girls, they pay the hostel fee, everything. But the girl here moves out and lives with the boyfriend. You know, love in campus is a bit overrated. You know, people, you know, we say that love is not, most people take as love, the attraction at first sight.
Sure.
I've not met you for the whole 17 years of your life. I'm meeting you for the 18th year. And for 5 minutes, I've already convinced you to be in my life forever.
That I love you more than your parents.
Everything. I love, I'm ready to take a bullet for you. I'm ready to do this and this. it is a bit overrated. People, you know, love is a feeling, it is emotions, it is being developed. And that is something that we young people don't understand about the issue of relationships and the whole circus surrounding it. We are really falling in love carelessly. And when we fall in love, we are being hurt daily and day and night. You know, it is only a fool, Levi, I'll say this, who all plays around fire and expects not to get hurt. It's only a fool who jogs around the same fire, the same pit daily, and expect not to fall into the deep pit. Because talk about 21-year-old, 18-year-old, 17-year-old, sit down with a girl. They tell you, I've been heartbroken 7 times. You wonder, seven times, amekuwa akifanya nini mara saba.
What do you think is fueling that, tell me?
But let me tell you, Levi, what about the social stereotypes back at home, whereby, actually I've experienced this, whereby someone goes to the university, comes back home, with, okay, maybe 4 years down the line, he or she hasn't gotten married evil. And the society, what they're telling him or her, is that kwani university kupatana na mtu. So, like, when
so there's an expectation.
Exactly, yeah. That's what society expects from us.
Yeah, but society is also, you know, it's now very different. You know, society is also not putting too much pressure on the whole aspect of marriage. You know, I keep wondering, why is it that you guys make your love, may patia kipaumbele? And yet love can still come at 30, at 40.
You know, Levi,
I mean, people are still loving each other at 50.
Yeah.
Okay.
To be sincere, Levi.
What's with the pressure right now?
We'll go back to the issue of peers, Levi.
Yeah.
All my friends have girlfriends.
You know.
I'll feel left out.
Yeah.
We go to class, people are holding hands. You know, I told you the other day, Levi, if I
in class.
To the
Even after the classes.
People are carrying
people
books for each other.
Exactly. People do assignments
my
for each other.
My phone's password, another, somebody knows everything about my phone.
My phone.
They do the assignments, they carry the phone, they put on matching t-shirts, you know. There's
oh,
a
really?
Lot for parents to see in campus that you haven't seen.
I'm now share my nguo
nyinyi wasichana. Yeah, girls, and they cook.
Jiko ndio utengeneza githeri.
Imagine.
Unapikia mtu wako na upikangi hiyo githeri nyumbani.
Imagine. And after all this, the end is now what we are talking about, suicide. Because I'll convince you that I love you so much, that you are my everything, all that. And there is a girl somewhere who knows and believes that Ezra is my first and is my alpha and omega. When he's not there, I'm done. So the moment I just come out of that relationship, and the girl is done. She kills herself or she kills me and comes better to kill herself. So the issue of relationships is a bit overrated and people are making careless decisions out here, which we really have to be looked at. And I think as we are discussing this, we cannot really underrate the fact that people fall in love. It comes and goes. It's okay. I see that feelings are like visitors. They come and go at any time.
Mm.
So you should be ready. You should not fall into love with the whole of your ears, the whole of your brain, the whole of your heart, everything into that person. That person can disappear, especially at this age of 22, 23, 24. Mm. You know, if it could be at 27 where, you know, I'm putting a ring into a finger in the next few months and that is forever, but people divorce.
Yeah.
But that
you know Ezra, how many parents are watching this wish that their children talk like you?
Yeah.
But unfortunately, that's not the case. Yeah, but I want to come to solutions in a bit. But then there's something else that that's also a factor that we have to talk about before we do that, is the issue of drugs and alcohol.
Yeah.
As a play for just entering into depression and suicide. You know?
Yeah.
Tell me, a lot of students go to campus when they've never dabbled with any drugs or alcohol. Like, I'm sure a large majority may not have tested pombe or, you know they've not smoked
actually
anything.
Actually, it's almost everyone who has never, you don't know and you know nothing about alcohol and all those things.
So how come when you have such a big percentage who have never tested, this percentage gets infiltrated big time by a few who have maybe have had elder brothers or there have been situations where the parents were not very, you know, strict and allowed them to test something, or there are those guys who, you know, they grew up without much control over their lives. These guys influence this
big percentage.
This big percentage.
Yeah.
How come?
Because first of all, as Ezra had mentioned earlier, we've got parties, you know. You're going to a party, maybe it's Ezra having a birthday party and I'm the friend to Ezra. So I'll attend that birthday. Reaching there, it's not sodas. No. I won't like our
Sika
parents.
Tunaenda. You know, that is what we say.
You're
not going to church.
Exactly.
You're going for a party.
So you always meet those people, and they'll always tell you, you just have a test of this. That small
tell me, you guys, what surprised you the most after you entered campus?
What surprised me the most, Levi?
Like in your first weeks and you're like, I
saw things, you know, there is some cool sense, there is some fresh air, Levi. there is some air I was not breathing in Eldoret. I came to breathe it the first at the gate of the campus. You feel there is some sense of freedom. So I have 1,000 shillings. Here, 1,000, I can use it the way I want. Any, my dad cannot tell me, Ezra, now this 1,000, you have to buy this. It's 1,000. Yeah, I can use it the way I want.
It was the freedom to do whatever.
Do whatever thing you want. So that was the most surprising thing. And in the evening, maybe after a week or so, now the parties begin. And the parties in campus are very wild, Levi. You know the meaning of wild? Like, people say we are not at Windy Church. Church is Sunday.
And no one is checking you, no lecturer, no nothing.
No one is checking on us.
Which lecturer? Hey. The lecturers finish their work, some even on Thursday. That is as early
actually,
as Wednesday.
Actually, parties in university have already started.
Thursdays and Fridays, parties have begun. And we play the immoral Gengeton lyrics everywhere, the air. The environment is immoral. Now the drugs are there. I was even some few days ago, there are some cookies that were spreading. Like cookies, normal cookies. Mm. Somebody's eating the cookie even in class. Mm.
But they're getting high.
Maybe do you know that? Yeah. Do you know that there is always this kakona in each and every university whereby people take drugs, you know? And there's no one who can say anything about that.
Yeah, and they know each other. Yeah.
But you have a guidance and counseling department.
Does it work? That's the question. Do they even always have their time?
And you have a chaplain, you guys.
You have a chaplain.
Yeah?
And we even attend chapel.
Yeah.
Some are Christian. You know, like the campus that we are in, they call
it's Christian based.
They say it's a Christian based university. But see the way we are talking.
You know, this even is very bad.
To put a lot of court and color on the same. Even when we joined campus, they gave us some set of rules.
Yeah.
You remember? During the dress code. But right now, a lot of things. Even girls are not allowed to see boys in our hostels.
Yeah.
Their gates are manned. But they forget students are living outside after first year. So it's the rules still apply.
So in campus, the rules are there.
Yeah.
They are not implemented.
Off school, it's very difficult. The number of times I'm in class with my lecturer is very minimal. When you in opposite of the number of times I'm outside
my peers,
here doing my own things with my friends,
it's
very minimal when you compare the same.
Wow.
Yeah.
The campus life. And then you, of course, you have a lot of access to this social media and stuff. You guys have free Wi-Fi on
free
campus.
Wi-Fi. Yeah, free
everywhere.
Wi-Fi in school. People are just relaxing under the sheds.
Earphones.
Yeah.
So then, tell me, considering that all these things are now really showing up in matters, depression, anxiety, you know, for exams, because by the time you're engaged in so many things, chances are you're not studying very well.
Do you know those people who go to the computer lab using the Wi-Fi, that even double those people in the library?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So paint the scenario that you have gone to campus and all these things are happening and you're, you know, under peer pressure, you're doing a lot of things you should not be doing. You're in parties, you're in what, and your exams are looming.
Mm-hmm.
And so now you're anxious.
Yeah.
You know, because you know now, for example, suppose and you're where the rubber meets the road, so to speak. That's where your parents may get to know, you know, that your seriousness has been wanting all this time.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have that exam anxiety, you've got, you know, you get students undressed, you get depression because even the friends who are supposed to help you are not happening.
Yeah.
With that kind of spiraling and those things happening, and people know that that's happening. What is difficult about students being able to recognize the pattern? Let's say even you are lost for a year.
Mm-hmm.
What's happening that the pattern is not being recognized, and why is it not being rectified?
Mm-hmm.
Why are we looking at statistics continuing, even though the problems are clear?
Yeah.
That they stem from here, they are from relationships, they are from finances, they are from, you know, drugs and alcohol abuse, they are from peer pressure, they are from, you know, what you call low self-esteem. Why are we not
rectifying this?
Yeah, why are you not rectifying it? What's happening?
I think the first
what's
case
stopping us from making
case,
that graph
go down? I think the issue is a bit, we should look at both sides of the coin. We should look at not only base our our problems or the main thing, we base our eyes and everything on the students alone. We have to base everywhere, the environment around them, all these, the parents, how they raised them, levy and everything.
Yeah.
I'll give an example.
It's a village matter, yes.
Yeah. I'll give, you know, they said that you can take a person out of the village, but you cannot take the village out of the person. So let's also get back to the base, to the foundation of all this. Deep calls unto deep. Let me use an example. You are a parent at home. You have got around 3 girls or 4 girls. These girls have never seen the fresh atmosphere of being left alone, freedom. You send them to the duka at home or to the small kiosk. You go with them. They come back. You give them a time limit. You tell them, by 7, I want you to be home. By this 6:30, I want you to be home. By this, I want you to be home. These, I'm talking about the parents, you see. And then these girls come to campus. If you've not instilled in them the measures, you've not told them why you are doing it. You know, we young people are in a place whereby you have to prove to us. We want concrete evidence as to why should I not do this? Why should I not enter into a romantic relationship at such an age? When will I enter into it? We have a lot of questions that are supposed to be answers. If only parents fit into the questions and answer us correctly and tell us, this is what I'm trying to do and it is for your own good. We should not, parents, you know, right now, most teenagers are seeing their parents as enemies. They're seeing them as potential enemies of their recreation.
Slave
of
owners and prison warders.
Yeah. Dad kulikuwa na time yako ya kushine, sahi ni time yangu ya kushine. Parents are trying now, no, my son cannot talk to me like that, I have to do this, I have to do this. We have to sit down with them and talk to them and tell them, this is what, why is it that I'm telling you not to do this? It's because of this and this. It is for your own good, it's for your own future, this and this and this. So, you know, I was looking at this level, if the current trend continues, we are losing a very huge cloud of generation. We are losing a whole lot of generation, a whole lot of young people in drugs. We are losing a whole lot in suicides. A lot of people are killing themselves outside here. So parents have to arise. The first issue is the parents. If the trend has to go down, parents have to be very, and it will not end today or next week or next month. It will start from the other generation that is young. We have to teach them right from the start all these values and the virtues of the society. I think that's the thing. And also the school has to inculcate some things into the system. The school should not be careless that it's a trend in campus. We should try and change some trends. We should try and tell them, convince them, tell them this and this. Try to be their friend. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's one of the things we should consider.
What would you say?
Maybe I can add on to that. I can say there's this famous quote, greatness requires internal toughness. So
say it, pole pole.
Okay, the blessed said that greatness requires internal toughness. So if greatness requires me internally to go internalize myself, and I'll outshine being that great, then I believe that if change is needed from me, then those people who are activating for this should come to the students and come to the youth and talk to them, even give them prizes like campaigns. Actually, I can say, from how I entered university, there's these campaigns that have always been done by the World Council of Churches, and I've always been attending them, and what I always benefited, because they're always giving us like a small data. So give us something which is promising, because maybe you can't tell me that you're coming for a campaign and expecting me to come there, and there's nothing you're going to offer these youth. These youth love to be enticed, come entice us, and we shall change.
If you want to save the same generation.
If you want to save this generation.
Yeah.
And that would be a good place to start. However, you know, we are also fighting the issue of you guys growing up into your own adulthood, making up your own minds, making up your own choices, you know. If, for example, you know, and parents would not be all the time around you, there's what parents can do at home, and you'll be confined to the house, because once you leave their home, that's it. And a lot of parents nowadays are trying. I've seen it, you know, trying to, you know, not be the parents who are parenting us. You know, us, our parents, were number one in everything.
Yeah.
And they never failed. They never... I think our era is the one that's going with that story.
Yeah,
you know?
Sure.
You know, they were perfect students. They were... all the teachers liked them. They never committed any, you know...
Mistake.
There's no one who was the last one.
Yeah.
They're always the best.
Never mind that you have a stepbrother who... is clearly from that era. You know, also, you know, you can do the maths, but we came from that era of parenting.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That parenting is sort of changing. There are some mm-hmm. who are still, you know, diehard strict, mm-hmm. and yet still a parent must still be a friend and still lay down the law.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
yeah.
Be able to tell you that apa kuna makosa. Now the difficulty here is that once you have left our
confines,
yes, and like you say, that you entered campus and the first thing you realized is.
Exactly.
I sleep when I want, I wake up when I want, I do what I want.
Yeah. I know, go to class.
I can decide to shower or not to shower, you know, I can, you know. You can decide small decisions, even big decisions.
Yeah.
Even going to class, you can decide
Even going to Mombasa right now.
Yes.
No one can.
You can go and still send pictures that you're in campus.
Yeah.
Until that tragedy happens and then we see Mtoto Kumbe alikuwa Nikoni fail.
Yeah.
And we don't know how. So in school, because schools have those centers that, you know, they say, like I told you, you have your guidance and counseling.
Yeah. Chaplaincy.
Who I think nobody ever goes to.
Yeah.
Or very few people
very few.
Goes
want to go
them.
To because, yeah. And then there is that whole thing of the stigmatization of you going to see your counselor and everyone saying that it must be because you are,
you know,
you are cuckoo upstairs.
Yeah.
So what do you think campuses can do or the campus environment can do mm-hmm. to make that, to give you that platform to be able to speak out your issues?
Okay, one thing I can,
other than being sent to an office to go and do them,
I can say mostly in this society whereby I believe that the youth, that they want to embrace it and talk to their peers. Like for me, actually, Levy, when I give a post of me going to Cast TV, you know, like a lot of youths will be like, Sheila, congratulations, and you'll come and tell us how you managed to be there.
Yeah.
So I believe.
So they will watch you,
exactly.
Even for curiosity like
yeah,
now.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So I believe that the youths are the ones to sensitize this matter to their fellow youths.
I think Sheila is saying a very crucial point, Levy. We should not even lay the blame, when the way you've said, we should not lay a blame much more on the parents, because most of the things are changing. You know, there are some time, there are some old school parents, those ones when you break the radio falls, it is your grandfather will come to rescue you, all those stories. But right now, parents are changing. The schools are trying to put some setups, though minimally, and it's becoming difficult. I think it is up to us, we ourselves. I think that is where we have to just hold the bull by its horns and say it is up to us. It is up to us. The few of us who know and discover themselves, it is up to us to go and talk to the rest. It is the few of us who know that and go. You know, a story is told of a man who was passing by and happened to fall into a pit. And a pastor came, passed by, told him, when you come out of this pit, come, I'll pray for you. A lawyer passed and say, when you come out of this pit, I'll go and sue the company that dug this pit. But there are some another man who came and went deep directly into the pit. And when they were inside the pit, the other man told him that, how have you come into the pit? We are now we are fools, two inside here. The man said, no, I know this pit. I have once been in this pit and I know the way out. So it is up to us, the people who are once there, there are people ahead of us who automatically face the problems that we should not be encountering. They should go back and tell them, it is possible for you to come out of suicidal thoughts. It is possible for you to come out of this. It is possible for you to come out of drugs and substance abuse.
Yeah.
It is possible because it is happening. How many stories of people are we hearing that they came from the same? So it is up to us, our own, the few influential people in the society, the few young people that know, you know, we need evidence. And it's true, we can show them by the pictures. Yes, as one see, and you can come out of the same. You know, a friend said while we were in the waiting room, and I have to quote this, she said that if you go and expose your problem, or you go and say your problem, it is like bleeding in front of a shark, which is this issue of stigmatization, which should be avoided and evaded by all means. And that is why most people are fearing the fact that they don't want to go and say, they don't want to go and expose them problems, they don't want to go and say the problems to other people. It's very difficult. So we have to, again, sensitize them that stigmatization is there and it is going to continue. Mm. So we have to be ready to face it. We have to soak ourselves into the storm.
We do. And I would love for us to sit with an even greater panel of young people and talk about these issues because they are of concern. And, you know, when you look at the statistical numbers, they're not very promising. Plus, even on that social media, it is young people who are trolling people the most and each other. And each other. You're vicious.
Yeah.
We have to go, unfortunately. There's a live events coming up. But I do appreciate this conversation. I'd like us to have it again next week if we can. Let's get a few more people in the panel. And let's try and help the young people who are out there watching and listening to us get out of depression. Because you can be able to get out of depression and suicidal thoughts. And you can do it before it's too late and before you end up doing something very drastic. So we're going to end on that note. Thank you so much for coming, Ezra Ruto.
Thank you.
Sheila Jep Kemboi. Sounds like I'm Kimbiaji's name. That's it from us here, 59 minutes. Join us next week for more of the same. God bless you. Have a good weekend. Take care of yourselves and each other.